Hello, welcome to our session of the Christian Meditation Prayer Group here in St. Mary's Church in Killarney. Thank you for joining us on our YouTube channel. I hope everything is good where you are. Welcome to everybody here in person. It's nice to see you. And we're going to prepare ourselves for our meditation straight away. So let us close our eyes and relax our bodies. Let go of the stress and strain of the day. And we remind ourselves that we meditate in the presence of God. And so at the sound of the gong, we bring into our mind our sacred word, Maranatha. And keep it there. And keep going back to it as often as needed. Okay, everything all right? Lovely. Everybody okay? Right. We've been thinking about some of the deeper aspects of meditation in recent weeks. But there's one particular aspect that isn't much discussed in the tradition, in the old early Christian writings. But it's really quite significant and important, and that's what I thought I'd talk about this evening. We are meditating in the presence of God, that is to say, the Divine Spirit permeates all of creation, is present, but you wouldn't know it, would you? You wouldn't observe it as a matter of course. The normal way of things, you don't notice the Spirit is present. The reason for that is the Spirit likes to be hidden. It's a really strange thought, that the idea that the Spirit of God wishes to hide so you can't see her. You can't find her. It's not something you could pick up like a pebble on the beach. And that opens up a fascinating possibility, because if the Spirit wishes to hide, you have to ask two questions. Why? And how are we going to see the Spirit if the Spirit hides? So the first question is why? Why does the Spirit hide? It's, first of all, the tradition tells us it's to do with the way in which the Spirit manifests. In the Bible, whenever the Spirit is spoken of, is most often spoken of as coming from a cloud. If you hear about a cloud in the Bible, then it's a reference to the Spirit. The Spirit is in the cloud. You can't see her. You can't see the Spirit. The Spirit hovered over the face of creation, holds everything together, so that the thing functions properly. You can't see it. The Spirit is like the wind. You don't know where it comes from or where it's going. You only feel it when it's moving. The wind, and it's moving. So that's the first question. There is a particular aspect to the Spirit that requires, that is part of the makeup of the Spirit, that the Spirit wants to be hidden. The second question then is, how on earth are we going to comprehend the presence of the Spirit if the Spirit is always hidden? And if you think about it a little bit more carefully, in our meditation practice, we talk about the darkness that we apprehend when we're deep in meditation, the absence of things. It's a kind of darkness. And this darkness is a manifestation of the hiddenness of the Spirit. When you hide something, the capacity to see it is removed, so it's dark. That's the logical extension. So we're looking for something that's dark, that's hidden, but we know it's there. So you have to ask then, what is it that is being hidden? What actually is it that's being hidden? The Spirit needs to hide, and hides in darkness. What is it that's being hidden? Why can't we see it? And why do we only occasionally get to see it? They're all the same question. In our meditation, what is happening is that we are preparing ourselves for that moment when the Spirit chooses to reveal herself. and the Spirit chooses to reveal itself, there's only one circumstance under which that can happen. And firstly, the reason for being hidden and the choice of the moment when the Spirit manifests to us is all to do with the power of God. The power of God. So when the Spirit chooses to manifest, chooses to be seen, the Spirit is only seen by those who are capable of surviving the experience. Surviving the experience. And I say it in that sense because it's not that we are good enough to see the Spirit. It's not to do with goodness or to do with cleanliness or to do with rightness or anything like that. There's nothing to do with that at all. What it is to do with is, are we sufficiently ready to be shown that amount of power, that amount of glory, that amount of radiance? Are we ready? Put it like this. If you were working in a steel furnace, you wouldn't walk up to the door of the furnace and open the door and stand there without some preparation, without some form of protection against the immense heat and light. So they wear special clothes and goggles and such like that to prepare themselves to withstand the power when you open the door of the furnace. And the Spirit shows, chooses to reveal herself to us when we are in that place where we're ready to cope with what we're about to be shown. And that you approach with a great sense of fear and trepidation, because that immense amount of power is so strong that you actually should be fearful of it, because it is way more powerful than we are capable of experiencing. So the preparation time is to prepare ourselves for that moment when we are deemed to be ready for the Spirit to show herself to us, because we can stand, we can cope with it. And doing so is called the fear of God. When we have the fear of God in us, we know the immensity of the power of God, and we are then prepared through a great sense of fear to cope with it. It's not something you do lightly. So there is that moment when somebody will be deemed to be ready, and it will happen to them. Sometimes we're given minute glimpses of it, just enough for us when we're able to handle it. Just enough, never too much. That is why the Spirit is always hidden. Because if the Spirit wasn't hidden, we'd be burnt to a crisp in an instant. Nobody can see God and live, is what Moses was told on the mount. Nobody can see God and live. What God did for Moses and for Elijah and for others was to show a remnant of having passed by. A remnant of having passed by. An afterglow, almost, if you will. So, in our meditation, we're preparing ourselves for that moment when we are deemed to be ready. And it's not us who chooses the moment. It's not us who deems ourselves to be ready. It's the Spirit that does it. So it can happen any time, and only sufficient for what we can handle. So have you any questions?
The only thing I've ever experienced when I was in London, Tess and I, we buried one of the lads, you know what I mean? And when you had to do things, you'd cope. It was afterwards, I went to pieces, really, you know what I mean? And then I'm being I just felt that God had been that day. But that's as near as ever I got to anything, really.
Yes.
I didn't see anything.
Yes. That's an interesting point, because there's an important difference there. If we're going to be allowed to be able to see the Spirit, then we have to have been made ready for it. Yeah? So we're ready for it, and then we can see the Spirit. But if life circumstances present us with some kind of event which is emotionally painful, we can't have yet been ready for it, because we didn't know it was coming, and it's happening to us by circumstance. And that's when we feel the presence of God holding us, because we need it, because we're not ready. We need it. And that helps us then to cope. Yeah? So that would be the difference between the two experiences. Any other questions? Any questions from the YouTube channel? Write them down on the space beneath and I'll respond to them. Okay?
All right.
Thank you very much for joining us for our session of the Christian Meditation Prayer Group here in St. Mary's Church in Killarney. I hope you're well. I hope the week ahead is good for you, and look forward to seeing you in person, if not on the YouTube, next Friday. Bye-bye.